Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's a signal generator from thru. It's called an audio generator, AG-202A. And this one is from the mid-70s, something like that. It's actually that old. And for the sentimental, I actually remember my father had one of these back in the old studio days. And the fun thing is I actually got a picture of him and his. I'll try and put it in here so you can see to the bottom left on the table. Can't you see it is exactly this type? I think that is super funny that I was able to get this one at the latest flea market. So let's see if this one still works. I spent the last hour trying to clean it up. No matter how much I clean this, it still creates all sorts of dirty, nasty lines and stripes, and it's just impossible to get this really, really clean. It was like balsamated into smoker stuff, so it was super, super yellow and gross. But now it's not so yellow anymore, but it's still needs some more cleaning. I connected this to mains, and all we have to do is, yes, we got a little lamp, neon, of course. So we are now in the look at that. So we got, is that 3 kilohertz? Is that right here? So that is 30 times 100. So that is 3 kilohertz. How amazing. So, well, it's actually more fun to dial this stuff and look at the scope at the same time. So that is 300, of course. And then clickety clack. And I can feel that something with, oh, look at that. The knob here is mounted all the way, so it's touching the metal, and that actually prevents the switch to go click click correctly. So that is definitely a wrong way to assemble stuff like this. You need to have just a tiny little do not touch distance so that the switch can operate correctly. But that is the 30 hertz, and that is the, no, it goes of course to 20. Is that accurate? Let's see if that is. Now you have your 20 hertz. So let's check out the level here. So this is the level on 20 hertz. Well, see, that is the switch I'm talking about. Yeah, because I could feel it. This switch is not able to switch correctly. Same level here in the next one. And that is the, okay, that switch is, I need to fix that. This is terrible. This is because there's no contact here. See? No contact. Fantastic. But if there is a contact, we have the same level, la la la. And then it goes, of course, to 200 kilohertz, so this is a little bit over. Audio range is, of course, to 20 kilohertz, so you have a whole extra. It's, of course, to check out your margin on amplifiers and stuff like that to see. You really want to go quite a bit over to test that everything here is good. Output attenuator in dB, and then a variable. Okay, fantastic. Now it's completely dead. What happened? Are you set? Oh, okay, that is why. That was user fault. So that is my pot meter here. Ooh, crazy, crazy, crazy. Don't worky, worky. Look at that. So that pot meter here is also up for some maintenance. But of course, this thing is, what, 45 years old or something like that. I just need to use it a little bit more. So let's have a look. What is actually, it's not that heavy. It only uses 5.1 watts. Now I am inside, I've already moved the two knobs. And as you can see here, scrabity scrabity. I mean, who would do that? This is really, really stupid. And you see what it causes of ugliness and pain. And then we had this scrape, scrape sound on this one as well. Now this, oh, it moves and do the clickety clickety. I just left it like a millimeter. And of course, there's some little adjustments and stuff here. So when you assemble the sides, you put in the screws here. And of course, you can adjust this to move a little bit. So this needs to, you know, have this kind of margin. But there's a really sexy weight here. So you can, I kind of like that. And it spins really nice and all that. And then there's just a wire going to the magic in here. And this is the electronics. And I found a little bulb. So that is the bulb for level compensation. Listen, that is super cute. And I've been looking around on all the capacitors. I can't find any leaks and anything at all. It's just super nice and clean inside. Yeah, okay, see this? But I mean, it's not that bad considering how disgusting it was inside. Outside, it was really, really dirty, but it's nice and clean on the inside, so that is nice and good. And here's this tiny little mains transformer. I don't have any exact date codes or anything like that, I can tell you. I was hoping to find a little label or anything like that, but that is not the case, no. I think we should have a look inside this, the magic box, the mysterious, super cool thingy in here, right? By the way, this is actually mains wires going like that to the on-off switch down there. And that is the neon bulb. I mean, yeah, that is the distance you get. How do I open this? Only on the top? This is actually really, really well made. So here's the capacitor. And the wires used for the capacitors goes through that little hole, and it's perfectly shielded. It's not even mounted in any metal like that. It's completely isolated. And the shaft is, of course, isolated as well. So, yeah. And that will be all the range resistors over here. And the fun thing is that all the ranges, they were actually completely right. All I want to do is clean the contacts, and then I'll see if everything is good and fine again. So that's what we're gonna do. So try and compare this picture here with my previous video clip. Can you see the difference? It's funny, I didn't see that at the first second, but it's like so obvious when you know it. Those two knobs, they were swapped. I mean, what kind of blind dude will do this? It's so obvious they need to be like this. This is the correct way. Oh my god, that is embarrassing. But now it's of course fixed. And I cleaned all the switches and all that kind of stuff, and look how cool that is. So it's really nice and good in all the ranges. And also, look at this pot meter here. Nice and stable. Yay. There's actually a funny little detail I wanted to show you. If we go into one, and then we go at 40, where is it? Yeah, here we go. I think it was 45 hertz. No, it was 43, something like that. So at a very special frequency, there is some sort of an interference with the time constants in the level feedback. I mean, isn't that funny? There's no ripple or anything anywhere else in this system, but at this particular frequency, there is like an unstable regulation, and you don't see that at any other frequency. Funny. Or if you go a little bit faster or something like that, oh, it's also here. But it's not a 50 hertz, at exactly 50 hertz. See, it's gone here. So this just reveals that this is not a mains frequency problem. That is a little bit funny. Maybe the bulb needs to be changed or something else. Maybe they all kind of do that. Yeah, 56. Oh, yeah. It's just what it is. This is, of course, not a reference kind of thing, but it's really nice and accurate when it comes to frequencies, and the range is good, and it goes stable real fast. You can actually, I think you can see that here when I change between the ranges. You can see this is the frequency, this unstable frequency here, right? That is funny enough, that is exactly what is needed to make this unstable behavior. Well, anyway, thank you very much for watching. See you around. Come back soon.